Hello everybody, welcome back to Scratch for Fun, and today we are doing a little bit more modding. We are working on our 1.7 here. We still haven't set up quite, you know, completely, you know, we haven't set up just yet. Now, first thing, all of these things, you know, at the side here is just, like, bugging me out. So I'm going to minimize all of the stuff right here. They are now in small icons at the side here. Now, you can always go to Window. And, you know, add some stuff. I'm not sure where it is. Navigate. Well, somewhere in here, you know, you can always just find these things again. show you, will basically show you all of the views you can get, basically. Open Package Explorer, stuff like that. You'll basically get it right away. So, Package Explorer right here. Let's do a little bit like so. You know, I have a big screen right here. Now, what we are going to do is we're going to set up some stuff because, you know, we need to set up. Now, right now we have a mod called Example Mod. Now, if you haven't already, just delete the line in here. Now, this is just, you know, how to set up a mod, basically. So we are going to follow that. So the first thing we are going to need is we are going to need a package. So in here, in this source /main/java, I guess you can go outside as well. Let's create a new, and you have this thing called source folder. Now we want to go inside source, which already exists, and then we want to go /, and then we want to choose our own kind of dealio here. So Scratch for Fun goes. Very good indeed. Now, what we're going to do in here is we're going to add some source, a package first of all. Now, of course, you can just type in your thingy name here, but the usual, the best practice for a Java developer is to write your domain backwards. My domain is scratchfun.net, so I'll do net.scratch for fun, and then a what I like to call initializer at the end here. This is like stuff everyone do when coding in Java. The initializer at the end here is basically the mod name, for example, in this case. So stuff, I'll guess we'll call it. And in here, you're basically going to do all of your coding. So create a new class. Let's call it as much as Scratch. Scratch. For fun, there we go. You can call it whatever you like, but we do need to kind of make it similar to the example mod class here. We will need this thing right here. This will basically tell it that this is actually a mod. So let's add that one. So let's go above here and let's say at mod, and no need to add the semicolon at end here. Let's import mod. So import mod. And then we are going to add some stuff. So add missing attributes. Attributes will add a mod ID. Now the mod ID is something we're not going to define right here because this is going to be used by nearly all the classes we create. So public static, make sure that it's public so all the other class can use it. Static, so you know that the class can use it without defining a new scratchfun first. A new instance of scratchfun, and then we're going to go, you know, public static, then we're going to say final as well. That means that it can't be changed, and we're going to go for mod ID. Now, if you set something to final, you need to initialize it as well. So we need to initialize it. Let's set the mod ID equal to scratch for fun. No need to capitalize anything at all, I think. So the mod ID is going to be equal to mod ID. Now, that's not how it works, because we're kind of outside of the class. So first of all, we need to call a class and then statically use this. So scratch for fun and then dot, and now you're inside of the scratch fun class and you can access the mod ID. Beautiful. Now, if you saw, we had a version attribute as well, right here, the version. Now, let's do the same deal right here. It's going to be a string version. You can capitalize like they do. I usually do that, but you know, who cares? Pre-alpha stuff 0.1. Never going to be updated again. Lol. There we go. That's my version. Now, I'm not sure if these things here work, but let's go for it. So, you know, everything is basically to the point right now. We should have a mod. Let's try it out. Let's run the client. The client is set to first. Let's try it out. And let's see if it launches our mod. It says 5 mods loaded. Let's go into mod here. It says example mod. And it says Scratch Fun right here. So the mod ID is it looks like basically the name of your mod. So that should be... it says version 1.0. Right there, okay. It doesn't say my version. Okay, that's weird. But Scratch Fun right here. Let's just change the mod ID. That's why you have, you know, this stuff right here. Now this one says version 1.0. That's because I just remember we forgot to add the attribute here. We added the string, but we didn't add attribute. So version is going to be equal to our version. So let's go in and access it statically. So go into Scratch Fun, which is the class right here, and now you're inside of these two thingies, and you, if they're static, can use the version and the mod ID. Now mod ID, let's capitalize stuff here. Scratch for fun, beautiful. Everything is working like it's supposed to work. Our mod is working. So let's quit game right here, and let's add the main kind of method, the method that's called whenever your mod is created. So for this, we're going to start with at event handler. This will basically handle some stuff for us. We can import this after we've done some more. We need to add a body, which means public void, and then init, I can't remember the method name. Let's go in here. Yes, it's init. Okay. And then you have the arguments fml initialization event, something like that. Let's call it e, and let's import initialization. I spelled it wrong clearly. So public void init and an fml initialization event, and go into event handler right here, import event handler, and beautiful. So this is basically going to get called every time we start up our mod. So system.out.println, this will basically print out yo 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 yo, stuff like that. So let's hit run, and if we go into our console right here, we'll hopefully see the yo 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 yo. There we go, that's a yo 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 yo. Our thing is here, our mod has basically been created. So if we go into mods now, we can see Scratch Fun pre-alpha version stuff, 0.0, never going to be updated, you know, stuff like that. That's the version we're currently in, who cares. That's how we roll. So let's do a little bit more of stuff. Actually, there's not very much more to do. Now, you can add a pre-initialization and a post-initialization event, but we're not going to do that right now. We're going to do that in later tutorials as we move and progress on, basically. But if you didn't know this, I'm actually going to post all of my source code out there on the internet. So there will be a video coming up very soon on how to download all of my source code for free, you know, stuff like that. So yeah, make sure you check that out once it's out. So yeah, goodbye and have a nice day. Woo!